I'm all good.
You're asking me questions.
It's up to you, I know there were.
Okay, so have you read the release form?
Yes, I have.
Okay, do you have any questions about it?
No.
Okay. Would you please tell us your name?
Dixie Powell.
Okay.
My maiden name was Neihart, and I've always lived in Milton.
What have you brought to the harvest today?
Well, I brought items, advertising items. This, of course, was a, I don't know if it was a soda bottle or not. Do I just, I can say it.
Yeah.
Joseph, M-E-N-T-Z-E, Milton, Pennsylvania. So I'm really not sure. It's a very old bottle, as you can see. I know nothing about it. I bought some of these items from a woman who sold antiques. Well, she had a shop on Cameron Avenue. It was Polly's. And you had to absolutely wade through the shop. The cats would run over the stuff. And I just happened to go in when some people were selling off some of their items. And I asked her if I could buy them. So I have quite a nice collection. This was Dreyfus Brothers Clothiers in Milton, Pennsylvania. It was on Front Street. And everybody, I mean, that was a great store. And, you know, I bought things there. And when they closed their doors, I bought a beautiful, well, I think it's beautiful, but plastic backed, but tapestry bag, garment bag, you know, for $25. I remember that. And I use it a lot. And Al Ullman was the guy, he didn't own the store, but he was in there. I don't think he owned it. But he was a very nice man, and you know, everybody in Milton shopped there. Milton was a wonderful place for our stores. Friday night, Saturday afternoon, the streets were packed. You know, we had so many shops, and of course, when the redevelopment came in and the one-way street, and then the mall started, so that pretty much wiped out. We had so many jewelry stores. We have one now. We have one shoe store, you know, but this town isn't the same that we knew growing up. And I have Broadway Shoe Store, 20 Broadway. And this is a headquarters for Bonnie Laddie Shoes for Boys and Girls. And it's a dictionary from, oh Lord, I don't know how long ago, 1926 edition.
Wow.
So I have a lot of advertising items. This is Charles Mays. They sold tombstones. And I grew up with Charlotte Mays because her father, when his father died, then Jared, I think was his name, and Polly, I played with Charlotte. I graduated in 1952 with her. And this is, I guess, a shoe buffer. So I think these items are wonderful. I wanted to tell about stories that have been lost in Milton. Can I briefly do that? Because I asked Kevin Mertz, you know, I was holding my bringing pictures, and there was a place called the Old Mill, and it was the VFW meeting place, and it was, everybody went there. The Lewisburg Hotel, or the Milton Hotel, and the Old Mill, they had a great big dance floor, they had slot machines, they had eating, and my stepfather was the manager. And his mother, Florence Wirt, and this is Paul Wirt, she cooked underneath this building. It was right by the railroad tracks. You went underneath the underpass going up 405 and turning at, what is it now? It's the EO meeting place. I don't know if you're familiar with Milton. So you turn, you go underneath the underpass, which of course is the railroad, and this building sat up on a little knoll, okay? And because my mother remarried Paul Wirt when I was 9, and my sister was born when I was 10, my brother when I was 12, you know, I spent time with Paul's mother at her home on Liberty Street. And, well, let's see, we used to go up, my mother was a hairdresser, Dixie Lee, named after me. She didn't have me until 10 years after they were married, and of course for, you know, 10 years, I was a spoiled brat.
Yeah.
But, so anyway, her beauty shop was in the Diener Building on Bound Avenue. Now it's in back of Lisa's Deli. Have you ever seen that in Milton on Broadway? Well, it was the Diener building. The plumber was in the bottom. It was Diener and what was the other name there? And they had apartments above. You walked up steps. My mother's beauty shop was here on the left. There was a barber here, and I used to wait around for her. We'd go to the second or first or second show at the Capitol Theater. I waited, you know, I'd sweep the floors or whatever for her. She'd always sit in the loge, unless it was a, you know, a really popular movie. And I remember seeing Gone with the Wind and The Wizard of Oz with her. And so then after my brother was born, you know, she gave up her beauty shop and one of her operators bought it. But we moved down to Liberty Street because this was Paul's mother's house. And when she got Alzheimer's, she moved in with one of his half-brothers. And she had a parrot. And the parrot used to come when we lived on Lincoln Street, and the kids that lived in the neighborhood, you know, they just loved this squawking bird, you know. It cussed, it sang songs, you know, and they had it for a long time. So I guess the parrot went with Flo when she went to with her one son from the first marriage. Her husband worked in a nail factory, and they think that the nail filings in his lungs killed him. So that's when she married Wirt, Oliver Wirt. And so I wanted to tell the story of Paul because he moved to Liberty Street to save money. He didn't have to pay rent for 2 years because he was in the process of working with Nice Patterson and some of the people who played on the golf course. And they had a deal that he would put, there was only nine holes, that he would put the other nine holes in, which he made it an 18-hole golf course. And so he moved to Liberty Street, and there was a barn. It was a working farm at one time, a big barn. And he made it into a restaurant. Beautiful. I remember the beams. It was so, so unique. And I'm pretty sure the first Saturday, the grease caught fire, burned it to the ground. So he built the present building up there, then put a swimming pool in. I lived there, we were on Front Street at the time, and I remember mother coming and getting me from the teen canteen to come home and stay with my brother and sister, and it was devastating to them, you know? But my mother moved from Northumberland to because her sister, Belle, Christabel was here, married a Newhart. She married a Neihart, my family. And she moved to Lincoln Street because then she paid my Aunt Belle to cook for me and watch over me. I was sick all the time, run over there and, you know, give me my comic books or whatever, you know. And her husband and sons, my cousins, they worked at ACF, which was very, very close. So her husband and two sons would come home for lunch and she'd have a good meal, you know, and I would eat with them. My cousin Kay was born later. She's a year and a half younger. So we were like sisters, and Belle would do her dishes and take us over through the cornfield to Chamberlain's to go in the river every summer afternoon. And the Kepler family lived in the house there. And it was so, from 5 to 12, I had the most wonderful childhood anybody. I love Milton. I lived catty corner across from the Lincoln School. We played there all the time. We went out at night and we played hide and go. And if you've never heard, bat the wicket. It's a wonder. These are games, no money involved, no money. So when they put the handicap, you know, corners for the streets, well, anyway, you'd prop up a stick and somebody would be in the middle and you'd take a stick and try and run these four bases without getting caught. Wonderful game. Rover, Rover, let the gang come over. Kick the can. It was wonderful, wonderful. A wonderful world that you don't know today. Yeah. Well, I guess that's about all. I just wanted to get in about Paul Wirt. There's nothing at all in any of the books. George Venus, I didn't know he didn't have this information, or I would have, you know. And this was an old gristmill. And the VFW, that's what they fixed up for their clubhouse. But everybody loved to go there. Right, Anime?
Right.
They danced, they ate good food. It was the place to go. And it's in Turbot Township. And this train accident over in Mosdale was one of my mother's best friends. She was in the beauty shop, which was Limbaugh's Bakery, which is now Lisa's Deli, the other part, you know, that's not open. Doc Keeley was in the part with Lisa's, and Bertie Case was in the little area, and they were wonderful, wonderful people. And Doc Keeley was open on Sunday night, so I had my allowance. I'd buy 10 comic books for 10 cents a piece, and by the end of the month, I was buying the classics. I loved reading, I loved my library, and I love this, and I hope Rose Hill goes on forever. Today's our book club, but I'll go get something to drink and a cookie, maybe. But that's quite enough, isn't it? So I do love my town. And it's gotten a lot of rap, you know, bad rap, but we know it when it was, and it's still a wonderful town.
For folks unfamiliar with Milton watching this video, what does your item tell them about your town?
That I love it, and they should have grown up here, especially in the early years. They missed out. Okay?
All right, thank you.
Thank you.